Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the NIBIRU channel. It is February 21st, 2017, and some very, very interesting video coming in by email this morning. And the other day, I produced a video pertaining to lightning coming from the sun. Well, lo and behold, one of our subscribers captured some video pertaining to lightning coming from the sun. This goes back to June of 2016. And as you can see, these plasma bursts of lightning, that's what I'm assuming it is. And the video is absolutely spectacular. Now, obviously, there are scientific reasons for this type of lightning or plasma bursts coming from the sun. What you're viewing now on your screen is the coronal hole that is facing the Earth, and this is one of the main causes. Also, since March 2015, elevations of stratospheric radiation have steadily gone up, and we've been talking about this for several months now because we're constantly under the gun and being barraged by these solar winds. And what you're about to view is a scientist by the name of Dr. Chris Scott. And they've done some extensive research on what causes this phenomenon. And it's very, very rare for someone to actually capture this on film. So we're going to go ahead and listen to Dr. Scott.
It's apparent, especially on a sunny day like today, that the sun is a major influence on our weather. But there are subtle secondary effects. If you go up into space, you can see the sun is this seething, fiery ball of plasma, and it rotates once every 27 days with respect to the Earth. You can also see there's material coming out from the sun, known as the solar wind. It's streaming away from the sun at about 400 to 800 kilometers a second. And as the sun rotates, these jets of fast and slow solar wind wash past the Earth. The Earth sits in the sun's atmosphere. So it shouldn't be surprising that the sun and the solar wind influence our planet. We know that it does to some extent because we have the beautiful phenomena that is the aurora borealis. That's the northern and southern lights, and that's caused by these energetic particles penetrating the Earth's atmosphere. What we've shown is that as one of these streams washes past the Earth, it brings with it a population of energetic particles that penetrate the atmosphere and appear to help modulate lightning rates. The accepted wisdom is that it's cosmic rays. These are very energetic particles caused by supernova explosions in the galaxy. These very energetic particles are known to penetrate the atmosphere, electrify the gas, and it's thought to trigger lightning. When the sun's very active, it has a stronger solar wind and a much stronger magnetic field in space. And this magnetic field protects the Earth from many of these cosmic rays. So you would expect when the sun's active to have fewer cosmic rays and therefore less lightning. But what we're seeing on much shorter timescales is with an active sun and one of these streams sweeping past the Earth, you actually have an enhancement in lightning because although you have got an enhancement in the local magnetic field, coming with that are a whole unique population of energetic particles which are doing the same job, we think, as the cosmic rays. Now, this has potential applications because we have studied our star from space for a number of decades now. We know that it rotates once every 27 days, and we can see where these fast and slow streams are occurring. And so potentially we can predict when they arrive at Earth. And if we can understand the influence of these solar wind streams on lightning rates in more detail, understand the processes, then that potentially leads to the possibility of some kind of long-term forecasting of the severity of lightning rates.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, something is interacting with our sun, producing these massive coronal holes, therefore producing the high solar winds, which is bombarding our planet with this solar radiation, or cosmic radiation, whatever you want to call it. And now, going back to June, this individual records this phenomenon, which is just absolutely amazing video. And I want to remind you, if you are not subscribed to the NIBIRU channel, please make sure that you hit that subscribe button and set your notifications and keep yourself updated. It's very important. Thank you for watching. I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce one of our new affiliate sponsors, Food for Liberty. And they provide the highest quality long-term food storage, water purification, and survival prepper supplies. All foods have a 25-year shelf life, certified non-GMO ingredients, and also a gluten-free option. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a very smart idea to have at least a 30-day supply of food and water in the case of any emergency. So there will be a link provided in the description box under this video for Food for Liberty. Hello everybody, welcome back to the NIBIRU channel. It is February 21st, 2017, and some very, very interesting video coming in by email this morning. And the other day, I produced a video pertaining to lightning coming from the sun. Well, lo and behold, one of our subscribers